Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's go see what happened to Sue, and that was awfully quick. Let me out of this instant. Hold your tongue. You're the reason Tarako got kidnapped. Our only chance is to turn you over to them and hope for the best. You creep-eyed freak. If we don't get Tarako back safely, I swear I'll tear you limb for limb. You couldn't even stop a tiny little girl. By the name of Tarako. So how the heck are you gonna tear her limb from limb? Come on, she's far tougher than you, King. Anyway, you talk to your King over here, and he'll be like, this is the fate of all who disturb the order of our village. So he's kind of using her as an example, too. Yep, I'm stuck. Doctor's minions kidnapped a Mamigma, thinking she was me. Her name's Tarako. That's that green-shirted girl, if you didn't realize. And when none of the other Mamigmas would have anything to do with me, she alone was friendly and kind. I know. Why don't you go in my place? My brother is in a location called Grasstown. Wait, brother? But he's human. That's impossible. You're a Mamigma, and... So, yeah, she tells you to go to Grasstown. I forgot to mention, in this building over here, we'll be back here a little bit later, you can talk to Jack and the King, like when you got Jack to move himself away from the cemetery. And may I add that this fireplace, there's something behind there. But I can't do anything about that just yet. But don't worry, I'll be able to do something very shortly. So, let's go back through here and enable the teleportation to Grasstown. And it's already connected to Grasstown, I guess. I clicked through that really quickly, but I was able to read it. And select Grasstown, and let's warp. Woo! Yeah. Oh, I forgot to mention something in the last two parts. This game has freaking awesome music. You can't understand the awesomeness unless you play this game yourself. That's why I say you should play this game yourself. Where do you get this impression that I'm a soldier? Wait, the war? What war? Power critters. Oh no, not the power critters! Anyway, there's this guy here. He's gonna say he lost his key to his house. His name is Santa! Where's my gifts? All I got was coal. Ah, well, whatever. So we gotta go get his key, and his home is over there. We can't get into his home without the key. And there's this barrier over here. It prevents critters from attacking, which is kind of interesting. It blocks out enemies. See that? I think that's the only barrier in the game that's like that. I always found that kind of silly. It's like a protection away from enemies. By the way, those ginormous things are power critters. And, oh, poopers! Don't let them fall on you, they do 12 damage, just like what happened to me. Oh, and here's a bundle of hearts. Oh, they do 6. I mean, they do recover 6, so that's awesome. So, yeah, don't let yourself get stomped from power critters, you know, from the top. And, so let's go shoot down the bats. And there's the key, in case you don't realize that. I just want to clear the way here. You know what, I'm gonna level up the missile launcher. Whoa! Feel the power of my missile launcher, and then the polar star to finish you off. Anyway, grab the key by pressing down, and there we go. Yay! So now we can go back over to Santa over there, and get him back into his house. You'd think a guy, you know, a guy that delivers presents all around the world every year in one single day would be able to get back into his house, but that's evidently not the case here. Alright. Really? A present? Finally! I'm tired of getting coal, man! Ugh. So, is your present spikes? Because that seems kind of dangerous. Anyway, now I'm going to... Actually, no, I would like to recover my health first before I save. That would be kind of helpful, obviously. So let's go over to this dude right here, and you're welcome! And what do you give me? I got the fireball! It's a new gun. Basically, these things jump... Well, I'll show you in a minute. Yeah, I am kind of looking for someone. I haven't seen anyone else, so I'll have to pass through the fireplace in Chaco's house. So yeah, there's a fireplace here, and there's a fireplace coming up at Chaco's house, and we'll see what Chaco's house is there. And there's a bed over here. What's interesting is that when you go to sleep, your health is restored, right? Well, what's the point of that bed if you can just restore your health over here? Yeah, I don't get it. Anyway, there's a signpost over here. It says, oops, watch out, death trap to your left. One touch means instant death. Really? Nah, that's impossible. No! Okay. I saw the shove it off. It does 127 damage. I don't know where he came up with that number, but I always found that number kind of silly. Maybe it's like the maximum value this game can handle or something like that, but why 127 of all things? I mean, the hexadecimal number is usually 255. You know, the maximum hexadecimal number when it comes to programming. So where did this come from? I don't know. Anyway, kill the power critter. Don't let it stomp on you and do 12 points of damage like it did to me earlier. I want that, thank you. I thought it was just out of reach there, but that's okay. I'm safe. So let's kill off the critters along the way as well. Just clear everything in sight. Killing all the local wildlife in Grasstown. May I add that there's a lot of grass in Grasstown. It is a natural wonderland. To which we've added the finest resorts facilities, a spectacular amusement park, and succulent seafood. Yeah, I was surprised too when I came to this place and found that. Anyway, there we go. And there's a missile launcher upgrade. It's a health upgrade coming. And this is the fireball, by the way. I forgot to show this off. They basically skim across the ground like that. I believe it is a very handy weapon. And because it has like sniping abilities and it has the ability to just roll projectiles across the ground. These bats are a little bit different. They dive bomb you and there's an instant death pit of spikes over there. But what we really want is to go up here for an upgrade. Just shoot your way up here and make a couple tricky jumps. There we go. Hello, life capsule. Woohoo! That's one of two in this area. And the other one's in a instant kill room, which I'll get to later with some things called presses. They're enemies. You'll see when I get there. And I would really like to level up my fireball. In case you don't realize, if you fall down there, yeah, you can just fall right down through there and there's a pit. It's instant kill. You don't want to do that. So let's just move on. And missiles. Nah, I want some weapon energy. Why did I press up to enter the door? I don't know, but this is... But that was kind of silly. Anyway, I always wondered why that you have to press down to go through things in this game or collect things, but I guess it makes more sense because, you know, up is to shoot upwards and stuff like that. Anyway, what you want to do is talk to Chaco here. Hello there. Goodness, that's a dangerous item you've got there. Are you a traveler? Yeah, kind of. You could say that. Beyond the flickering flames, you spy a hole. Flames are in the way and you can't get past. Oh, you'd like to go through my fireplace? Then you'd need the jellyfish juice you can get from the jellies. Okay, so go to bed here. And, yeah, you can only do this the first time through the area. And health is restored. Okay, so wait a second. She's in bed. I had my health restored. Something seems awfully suspicious here. Let's go to our inventory. Chaco's lipstick. Excuse me for a second. Ah! Hey, I wanna die, actually. Thank you! The sweet release of death. Yeah, actually. In case you didn't realize, that was a little reference to something quite adult-like. And yeah, that thing will still be in your inventory. That lipstick is a Easter egg item. If you check the fireplace, and then you go to bed the first time you visit her, excuse me, she'll be in bed, she'll give you the lipstick, and the rest is history. Anyway, these are jellies. Now, they now appear after having that one-night stand with Chaco over there. So, I don't know how that works. Maybe it's jelly in more way than one. I don't know. But let's just not question it too much. I'm having nightmares, and now we gotta go get some jellyfish juice. This jellyfish juice is how you get inside those fireplaces, and that's how you get the items from within the fireplaces as well, or go through secret passages. You only have to get 3 jellyfish juice through this entire game. Well, that I know of. I don't remember having any more use for the jellyfish juice after it's over, and that power critter is going to attempt to dive bomb me, but it failed miserably. And failed miserably again. Okay, I was just a little bit worried about that because it was like in a sniping position where it could just plop down on you. Okay. Careful. Oh boy. No, I don't think so. Okay, everything is safe. The path is cleared except for this area, which is now filled with a load of jellies, and you'll see a giant jelly if you climb upwards from here. Ow. I did not mean to get hit by the little critter there, but that's okay. And come on, thank you. And keep climbing upwards. These jellies, they do a lot of damage if they touch you, but they really don't get in your way all that much, honestly. They're just like there. They don't attack you, they just float in midair. And you'd think a jellyfish would need water to survive, but that's evidently not the case. Anyway, this giant jelly up here, don't destroy this block over here, it makes defeating it a lot easier. Just shoot it down like this. See that? It prevents you from being touched by the jelly. Then you open the treasure chest, and you get the jellyfish juice. Yay! And that's how you get the jellyfish juice for all circumstances. So once you use up a jellyfish juice, you'll be able to get another one. That jelly will reappear. But until you use up that jelly juice, it will not reappear. Anyway, what I want to do, actually, before I go any further, is go back to Arthur's house and in turn Mimigma's village and collect an item from within one of the fireplaces. Remember that fireplace back at Jack's house? Was it Jack's house or King's house? Well, I know which house it is anyway. I'll read the sign when I get there. So just climb up here. Oh, it's the assembly hall. I guess it's just not anyone's house in specific. Anyway, yeah, I'll use the jellyfish juice on this fireplace. And what's this? The bubbler! Woohoo! That makes me happy. This is a new type of weapon. Right now, it's extremely weak. It has this range, and it only does one damage. Don't worry, once you level it up with some energy crystals, you'll get a lot more use out of this, trust me. So make sure that you collect as many of the energy, weapon energy, as you possibly can. And let's go back to Grasstown and get some more jellyfish juice for the other fireplace in Santa's house. And that's really all there is to it. Nothing more to say here, so let's cut ahead and get some jellyfish juice. Okay, I level up my bubbler here, and now it's turned into an automatic bubbler thing of sorts with a much better range. It acts sort of like a shield as well, so this is where it starts getting handier. At level 1, it's pretty useless, but at level 2, it's getting there. Level 3, you can pretty much create a shield, and I mean a complete 360 shield around you of like bubbles and lightning, and you'll see when I get it to level 3. Anyway, let's kill off this jelly again for more some juice. And I got the treasure chest and the jellyfish juice from within, and of course I cleared the way back, so let's just do a quick trip back. I don't think I need to cut forward again, because as you can see, it's just a very, very quick trip. And here we go. Let's go into the fireplace. Yes, this is required to progress in the game. The bubbler that I got back in Mimigma Village is a optional gun that you can get, but I still recommend that you get the bubbler, if not just to try it out for yourself. And that's the charcoal. I'll need that to make an explosive later, actually. But as for now, I'm gonna save my game, get another jellyfish juice, and go over to Chaco's house. See you then. Okay, here is the bubbler at level 3. It's again another type of automatic gun, but what's interesting about this is here's your 360 shield here, and they pop randomly. So what happens is that you get not only a shield, but you'll also be able to shoot enemies from multiple heights at the same time. And when you release the button, you'll be able to shoot all your bullets at once. Well, I should say bubbles at once. Something like that in a big wave. It does a lot of damage to enemies. And I got another jellyfish juice from the giant jelly. So let's go over to Chaco's house and continue on. Actually, what I probably should do when I get there is save my game and end this part off. It's getting kind of lengthy, so yeah. And I really shouldn't talk about time too much in my videos. I mean, who wants to hear about the time in videos? And again, time is kind of a factor in keeping people watching videos. Like, if a video seems too long, you'll be like, ugh, don't feel like waiting that long. So I guess time is kind of an important thing. Anyway, here's the save point. I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you in the next part.